Welcome. I'm still slightly setting up a little bit. I need some place to pop open my book of finger bones. There, yeah, that's better. Need the bones. So for people who don't know who HTN is in the title, Harrow the Ninth. It's a book series. I am obsessed. And I got the crazy idea yesterday of doing like sort of Renaissance inspired ish portraits of God and the lictors, Harrowniathi included. So I'm following my little happy serotonin brain because I thought of a cool idea, because I have Black 3.0 and I've never used it. I've had it for almost a full year now, and I'm always too intimidated and scared to use it. So I'm just gonna use it for Harrow the Ninth shenanigans and Art of God and Lictors. Also, I have nails on at the moment. Well, one of them's in my car and needs to be glued back on. But we're gonna find out if I can draw with nails on and if I'm going to get super frustrated and say fuck it and rip them all off in 5 minutes or not. But my initial idea is like a sort of head only, maybe head and shoulders portrait of God, because just want to use the ultra matte black to do fun eyeball shenanigans. So we'll see how that goes. I should take this off because I am going to paint it. I want to do minimal paint though. I want it to be primarily ink, I think, between my nice fine tip pen that is. There's my brush pen. Yeah, let me knock everything off of that one shelf on my desk. That's great. There's that pen and. Oh, Boise, where's my other good pen that I've been doing a lot of my sketching? Well, I should be doing a lot of my sketching with, because let's face it, I fell off of that wagon. One of these days, I will do a prompt thing and actually stick with it for the entire length of the prompt thing and not just burn out and not do it for more than like 3 days. Is it still with my sketchbook? No, because that's my sketchbook. But I'm gonna do stuff in place first. So we will get up and find that pen when we actually need it. Yeah, I didn't want any brush pen and that, because they're both waterproof. Yeah, this is waterproof. The other pen I know for a fact is waterproof. Because I could do all the pencil and ink and then do a combination of like the black 3.0 and like maybe a little bit of gouache to go with it, or more likely some like really light watercolor washes to give a hint of color. I just want to try painting solid black, white rings, oil slick eyeballs. That just seems like a fun subject. It just seems like a fun subject to paint when you don't have a piece of cat hair or an eyelash or something in your eyeball like I currently do. Turn out nice. I might couple prints of them either on my Etsy or fingers crossed at some conventions / art shows that I'm going to start trying to apply to now that I'm mostly settled and have at least a part-time day job. Your paper, yeah, things like cable fees and whatnot. What is that? No, that's my nails rubbing on the paper. But I just need another big one. Well, we're gonna make this work. If that keeps happening, I'm just gonna start popping all these off. Hopefully not the case, because I just put them on the other day. However, I did already have one pop off. It's in my car. I just forgot to grab it when I came inside, so I haven't glued it back on. But, like I said, cross that bridge when we get there. Holding things like this, and I really like their artwork. Maybe there's a secret to this. Maybe this will help me. Developing my own style in a way. Will maybe less of, you know, like a copy machine, copying what other people have already done. I had stuck with doing the whole daily sketches every day in October thing. Probably would be doing pretty well, but you know, life happened and I didn't really stick with that the way I planned on it. Such is life. the nose and the mouth pretty consistent, I feel. Okay, because I did kind of like how the mouth looked. Joining me. Hope you've been having a good day. I'm also doing all right. Had a pretty chill morning. Look really weird to me. Like, it's hard to imagine how they're going to look like three-dimensionalized when they're like still flat rough sketches. I don't know if that makes any sense, but it's like I look at it and I'm just like, yep, that's, I guess that's a face. It's just weirdly proportioned, but like it's because there's depths that I can't really get without pencil shading, but I'm not planning on doing the whole thing in pencil. Thank you. Okay. That was my issue. I was drawing the eyes too low. Okay. I feel like that looks much better. See if I can adjust my light a little bit. My shadow isn't like fucking everything I draw. Thank you. mean the commission watercolor from you keep here. Oh, thank you, yes. I appreciate that. What character have you been thinking of getting done? Is it like a fan art one, or is it one of your original characters? My original characters. I love that. I love doing original characters. I keep drawing my D&D party. Yeah, I don't really do a ton of fan art. I mean, I guess the screen cap redraws I've been doing are technically fan art. And then, I guess this would also technically be fan art, since I'm doing a character from a book series. I don't know, I just prefer doing original characters. I think they're fun. I just had such a fun potential idea for God and the Lictors from Harrow the Ninth that I was just like, I'm just gonna do that today. I'll have that be what I do today. My collar. Kind of bones there. Doorbell. I will be right back. I'm gonna go check on that. Thank you. I'm back. I regret ever leaving. We've been trying to reach you about your car's extended warranty. Which, you know, having a car that's over, like, 10 years old at this point. I'm aware that the extended warranty probably no longer exists. Please leave me alone. Probably like my favorite trope ever in pretty much every form of media is almighty and powerful God is actually just a guy. And he is so tired. Over top, and then I should have some fun with the black 3.0 that I have. I have some blue lit too. Maybe I'll do that since eyes glow. A little white rings in them. That could be fun. Rough enough that I would be confident going in with pen? Debatable. Absolutely debatable. what do you start going then? Does that mean I need to get up and go find my nice pen? Absolutely. For some reason, it's not on my desk. Locking my beanie on this light, I need to move it.
Where would I have put that? I thought it would have been on my sketchbook, but it's not.
Actually, before I go in with pen, I should probably do some little things.
Thank you.
the middle bones of the fingertip. Pen. I can start inking this. That should be fun. Thank you. favorite pen. I was doing all of my sketches with it. A little bit. Thick in regards to what I'm going for. Now I could do. I could do this. But I am fairly terrible and out of practice. I did kind of fuck up a little bit on the. The other one I did. With this ink. I don't know if I trust myself. So I was gonna use some of that ink, but I was gonna use it, like, you know, with a brush. I don't trust myself. Ow. Like, I just literally stabbed myself with one of those. Well, done with these, we'll see how we do. The worst that can happen. I ruin it, and I try again, and I do it better the second time. gonna lie, I'm tempted to do the whole thing with my brush pen. I think I will. Why not? Why not do the whole thing with brush pen? Because I can get some pretty decent fine lines with it. Why not? Erase that. Breakfast. Although my other pens feel more like a gray, like a really dark gray to me, whereas this is actually black. Thank you.
Okay. Ink needs to dry first. That would be a smart thing to know. This is still fixable. I can still fix this. This is fine. I'm just gonna let that... You know what? I'm gonna let that dry. Bust out my watercolors and get some black 3.0. One part water, stir into super base. Acrylic medium or linseed oil. Resin before, but now that I'm thinking about it, I don't think I have. I think this is the first time I've ever opened this. This is I have some watercolor medium that I think I'm going to use instead of water. Let's see how this goes. But I think the black 3.0 and the blue lit I'm going to use is like constant with all of the portrait. Smudging everywhere now. Huzzah. Actually up here in the walls.
It's a resounding no as I look around the room. So I'm going to do
thank you.
Hi! Hi, Cat and Axel. Hey, Cat. How have you been? I feel like I haven't talked to you forever. I really need to be more than Cat. I have no idea how long that's been sitting there.
Pile. Pick the brush hairs out. probably invest in a hair dryer so I can dry my layers. So it doesn't take so long to like sit and wait between them. Going? It's going pretty good. I just got one of my tattoos touched up yesterday. I got to drive all the way to Arkansas. So I got to go to Arkansas for the first time ever. Fortunately, didn't do much while I was there, but it's fine because my tattoo is touched up. It was a nice drive. Yes, Arkansas. What the hell's in Arkansas? Really not much aside from state parks, bars, and coffee shops. And one of the tattoo artists I really like. Because they travel from Dallas to Oklahoma City to Arkansas. So happens that since I moved, the Arkansas location, even though it's in a different state, is the closest. Also, because taxes are different in Arkansas, they charge a lower hourly rate for tattoos in Arkansas. So I guess lucky me for getting that little bit of a break on the hourly rate. The more you know. Yeah, I know, right? Because I was, while I was there, I was talking to her and I was getting an estimate for my next tattoo so I can figure out how much I need to save up before I can, like, start the booking process. Because I don't want to start the booking process and then be like, oh, just kidding, I don't have enough money yet. She was like, yeah, you know, it's kind of beneficial you being closer to the Arkansas studio because taxes are different in Arkansas. So I charge less of an hourly rate. It's like, oh, okay, that's cool. But it's a pretty drive through, like, farmland and state parks. I mean, that's pretty much all there is in Oklahoma, too, is farmland, state parks, cows, tornadoes. Tattoo artist moved like an hour away and she was down the road, and if I mean to trot over to arrange my next piece, keeps slipping my mind. That and the pandemic. Yeah, I was like so gung-ho excited to be like, yeah, gonna get so many more tattoos, and then
pandemic happened. So I've only gotten the one new one. But living in a different state means I get to add to my state flower sleeve. So. Really, you should get a tattoo every year for my birthday. It's after the last two. Aww. Yeah, up until, when did I get done? July? Up until July, the last tattoo I got was the one I got with all my birthday money, like, 2018. Gaming chair and a keyboard piano, so their tattoo price range. Nice! I would definitely probably benefit from a gaming chair. I feel like I would be less of a shrimp when I sit at my desk, as I am currently a shrimp. It's terrible for my back. I have enough back problems as it is. I should probably try to avoid being a shrimp when I can. The keyboard piano is cool. I've actually... Had I known, I would have just sent you mine. Need to list mine to sell it, because like... I haven't touched it since I moved in with Michael, because Michael's got a full-size electric. You know. So I don't really need my keyboard anymore. Let's see if the second coat of this stuff is more opaque. No, not really. I wonder how blasphemous it would be if I just added, because I have black 1.0 in the powder pigment, because I got it for doing resin stuff, but I wonder how blasphemous it would be if I just, you know, tried to boost the opacity by adding some of that. Yeah, my last tattoo is the bee's knees. Oh, I remember your bee's knees! Those are adorable. I haven't been able to travel for the last year, so I put the travel money instead to clothing and costumes. Nice, very nice. I'm used to do so much costume stuff, and I've kind of migrated from that to doing more art stuff instead. Partially because of pandemic, I feel. It's like, I could make awesome kick-ass cosplays again, but got nowhere to wear them to. So I've been, like, all of my fun money's been getting funneled into D&D dice and art supplies. Well, it used to. Now it's all funneled into recovering from the cost of moving. Definitely more opaque. Just kind of thick. What if I do just a touch of super paste in there so it's not super chunky? Oh, that's nice and smooth now, yeah. Yay, moving. Oh god, it was... Oof. Moving states is not fun. Also, since it was for job relocation, they like sent people to pack our apartment for us. It was one of the weirdest experiences I think I've ever had, is people showing up being like, hey, we're here to pack your stuff for you. Like, because we didn't even know until they sent people and the people showed up that they were gonna do that. Yeah, I gotten so many pieces, especially from Holly Clothing this last year. I want to get stuff from Holly Clothing. Like, the only costume place I've been recently is, for my birthday this year, since the Ren Faire was open. And since it was open air and not indoors, we went to the Ren Faire. Like, we went for my birthday weekend, and then we went, like, closing weekend? Yeah, my birthday weekend and closing weekend. Because, like, almost none of it was indoors, so we were like, well, we're both vaccinated, everything's outdoors, the weather's actually nice, I just... put my arm in wet ink. So we were like, let's do the Ren Fair, because birthday of the year, everything shut down. We were going to go camping at the Ren Fair for my birthday, and then everything shut down the month beforehand. So. But I would not mind getting some stuff from Holly Clothing. I also hear their dresses have pockets. Went to the Ren Fair last month, first time dressing up for as well. Congratulations! I have been dressing up for the Ren Fair since the first time I ever went to a Ren Fair, which is when I was like 4. My aunt was a huge Ren Fair nut, so she would like dress me up as a little fairy and take me with her, and then I just immensely enjoyed playing dress up, so my parents, my grandma would be like, yeah, you can dress up for the Ren Fair, you're a cute little kid. And then I never grew out of it. I continued playing dress up for up until I went to the Ren Fair and dressed up the entire weekend I was there. So I still play dress up. But I hope you had fun. I was gonna go to TRF this year, but like, since it's now, it's gone from like a 5-hour drive to like a 12-hour drive, so I probably won't. But I have to find some new Ren Fairs that are not a 12-hour drive to go to. I don't know if they have any going on this winter or not. I might have to wait till spring. I know there's a couple conventions, like anime conventions and Comic Cons coming up, because I need to start applying for booths for those. First successful convention booth, and then, you know, the plague made everything close. And I once again just put my arm in wet ink. The ink on the tape is not drying, and I keep resting my arm against it. Okay, so I'm gonna just wipe that, and then I'm gonna turn this upside down so I stop resting my arm in ink. Also, Kat, I saw your Halloween art that you posted of your D&D characters dressed up for Halloween, and I absolutely adore it. I love and miss Sylphira dearly. I actually had her on my, because I was going to fill out an entire page and of just rough sketches. Oh, I just smacked my camera. I'm sorry for the wibble wobble. But I had her on my list of daily character sketches for October, but then I only did, like, the first 7 days, and then got way sidetracked with everything else. Threw them back in, like, mid-September. Oh, I bet it's been hell keeping them to yourself. I always want to be like, aha, look, I've made a thing! It's me with the tarot card Christmas presents, which I still need to mail you yours. You're gonna get last year's Christmas present this year with this year's Christmas present. I still have that the watercolor painting of Evan. For some reason I thought I mailed it to you, and then like I was unpacking my office and I pulled out the portfolio that it's in, and I was like, oh hey, I guess I still have this. Whoop. How it goes though. I don't know where October went either. I have like almost none of my Halloween stuff out, and it makes me very sad, but like I still have stuff that's in boxes that needs to get unpacked. The first week off is a staycation, and suddenly Halloween is this weekend. Yeah, I feel like we moved in. I don't think we moved last month, but like I feel like we just moved in 2 weeks ago. It's kind of ridiculous. And like I was tracking really great with doing the daily October sketches, and then I finally got a part-time day job, and then I got a second one, which is great because I quit the first one already. It was such a nightmare. So I was lucky enough to get the two part-time jobs so I could just, the terrible one, I could yeet myself out a window and never return. Like, I didn't even go in and turn in my 2 weeks. I just emailed, like, hey, I resign as of immediately. It was a mess. The entire store was a hot mess. But, like, between that and, like, trying to, like, get my change of address filed, and I need to get my license and my car tags changed over, and it's just... I feel like the month disappeared instantly. Just moved back in July, and I feel like that was just 2 or 3 weeks ago. Yeah. No, October, basically November now. Yeah. Where does the time go? Like, absolutely insane. Also, this does dry really, really matte now that I'm putting it on in a thicker coat. This is exciting. Doesn't help that I have boxes still unpacked of art that I'm not gonna hang up because I'm getting my own place next summer, so why hang it up? Oh. Yeah, I feel like, because we don't have any of the artwork and stuff hung up in, like, the living room or the bedroom, it's really just my office that I've hung up stuff. So it just feels like I don't really live here, because I have so much art stuff. For everyone that just moved state. That is terrible, and... that just really sucks. Because the apartment, I was, we were there for like 4-ish years, so like, it was very much lived in. Although I'm not gonna miss it at all. Because everything kept breaking all the time, always. And the carpet was a nightmare. But like, we just got like halfway unpacked here and it's already like, oh, well, what if we relocate, like, in a year? What if we relocate next summer? Which, rather than just hopping, like, 5 hours over into a new state would probably end up being like, let's hop over to the West Coast. Up in Washington, which is a very drastic change. We were cramped in a one bedroom for 2.5 years, finally upgraded to a bigger place, like an office. But now I have to downgrade back to a one bedroom. It's like, I should have just stayed put. Aw, oh, that, yeah, that sucks. Such is life. Ain't that just the way? I don't know if you've seen, because I've talked about it and yelled about it on Twitter a little bit, but there's the Locked Tome book series, Gideon the Ninth, which I have read, Harrow the Ninth, which I'm almost done reading, but This Is God, aka John, just a tired guy trying to survive the millennia. But I got this idea. This is God. But I have the black 3.0, which is like the super matte absorbs light black, and then I've got the blue glow in the dark lit pigment, which glows pretty bright. So I got this idea to do God and all of his saints as paintings. I'm glad I can entertain you in such a way. But I got the idea to paint God and his saint, because one of his saints is Harrow, who's the main character, whom I love very dearly. Also, one of his saints is Anthe, who I love very dearly, but she is terribly, terribly, terribly a bitch. But yeah, so I figured I'd start with God, because he's got weird eyes that I just really wanted to try painting. Because they're like matte black sclera, and then he's got like white rings, and then his irises and his pupils are like oil slick black. It just sounds very interesting. Also, he has laurels with infant finger bones in them, because, you know, God is a necromancer. That does sound very interesting. I think you would enjoy it. It's about necromancers in space, but also, like, all of the main characters are lesbians. And it's just wonderful. And I immensely am enjoying Harrow. I can't wait to finish reading it. And I'm also very excited for the next few books to come out. Also, at the part in Harrow that I just read, because this is kind of spoiler-free to say this, God makes a reference to the meme, Nun Pizza with Less Left Beef. It's hilarious. BRB. Okay. I shall repeat that when you come back. Because I was upset when such a reference was made. Now, I need to figure out how I'm going to do oil slick black. That is the dilemma.
Thank you.
always remember none pizza left beef. Indeed. God's like, what would my houses be left with? What would I be left with? It'd be none houses left grief. And I was just like, that is a meme, sir. Sir. That is a meme. My ferments are God, referencing memes? More likely than you think. My pen doesn't run, but the black sure does. Terrible. It's easy for me to just be like, well, add water and it'll go away.
Thank you.
very harsh lighting in it, so I'm doing my best to sort of emulate that. That got snagged on my reference book. Let's pull my headphones out. Or not out, off. I wonder if black gold would probably be good for the oil, sort of oil slick look. Or describe his eyeballs. I bet you that'll look cool with the... the matte black and the... the white rings. I say white rings, but they're gonna glow in the dark blue. They did put some of that light on them. It's not the whole rainbow, like oil slicks really are, but I think that's a good way to present it in a painting. So, being insanely way more talented than I currently am. I am gonna try and do... the ropes are supposed to be... which makes me think of like a university fabric, so I think I am gonna try and do some really faded... washes of color in the robe and on the world pages. Thank you. guess that I have an opal ring that I can reference.
But like they kind of, a majority of them seem white. I just want to do like little, like some really dark pops and sometimes really washed out ones. I don't know, we're just gonna have fun with it and hope that it turns out somewhat decent. How to best paint an opalescent fabric and have that translate in a static painting. I think I'm just trying to do like really water washed highlights and shadows. Lighter than the rest of his face. Proving a little different to not get all the way back. And that's what I put on the little flex of bone. looking a little bit more tie-dye than opalescent, but I think the point gets across enough.
really washed out on camera as opposed to in life. What if I tilt my light so the light's not directly facing him? That's a little better. You can kind of get a better idea of what he looks like. Yeah, the light I'm using so I can see what I'm working on. My office is unfortunately quite dark. Kind of washes out what it looks like on camera. Which is just more of an excuse for people to check out my coffee, my Ko-Fi. Because today and tomorrow I am working on updating that. And scanning all my new artworks and getting them all like super duper nice looking and posting them over there so I can start updating those more regularly or start updating that page more regularly. Start having more stuff over there. But let's keep wash going. On the collar and in the world, then this piece will be done. Like, I'm not super happy with the watercolor washes, but I wanted them to be kind of light and watercolor washy. So, like, makes sense that they're like that. I really need to clean my gouache palette. Gouache palette's looking kind of sad. Thank you! Looking good, thank you! Just gotta paint some bones! And I think I can call God done. Which, now that I'm realizing it's almost 3 o'clock, means I can also probably call it a stream and go get some lunch! I don't want it to be super duper light. I forget what the terms are. It's... I don't want them to be... What is it? There's like 4 different food hells yeah, lunch. Yeah, lunch, absolutely. There's food-related words for the consistency of gouache. It's like, there's something, and then there's tea, and then there's milk, and then it's cream, and then it's butter. I was watching a gouache class online. Brian, you know. Actually learn art to be better at it. I think I just watered the white milk. See what I was playing for cream. We'll see. I was a color pencil artist before I was a digital artist, so I have no idea. Yeah, I still feel like I am absolute garbage at digital art. I've got a stylus. I've tried with using my iPad and my stylus. I still have no idea what I'm doing. I draw better on paper and whatnot than I do on a tablet. So I'm just gonna stick to my traditional art. Yeah, I don't know how to. I don't have to know it. You don't have to know it to draw it. That's like how my friend telling me I need to know how to read sheet music to play piano. Will it help? Maybe. Do I need it? Fuck no. Just show me the keys to smack. Yeah, I can't read sheet music, but I can play a couple things on the piano. I look at sheet music and I'm just like, I'm sorry, what is this? No idea. But did I teach myself a couple songs by watching people on YouTube and looking at what position their hands were in and what keys they pushed? Absolutely. call it spaghetti language.
I mean, you're not wrong. It is all lines and dots. It is absolutely 100% all lines and dots. It's all lines and dots that translates to letters, which translates to keys. Which all in all just means it's very confusing. But I've been doing like, not necessarily like art classes, I've just been, you know, watching other people do things with like gouache and watercolor in videos, and I'm just like, okay, I see what they're doing. Not necessarily because I don't know what I'm doing now, but just so I can be like, ah, I know the names of things now and techniques. I look at sheet music and the first thing I go is, I can't read this, everything is too small, and I feel like a grandma. Oh. Honestly, that's me with, like, things in super fine text, like, super fine print on, like, computers and stuff. It's like, oh no, I'm suddenly blind and can't read. Oh no. Where's the harpsichord mode? Where's the sustain button? Boom, I'm a virtue virtuoso. Hey, Macarena! Yeah, I always just, like, liked with my keyboard. I got it so I could learn how to, like, properly play. But then it just turned into, look at all these fun modes that it can do. I'm gonna just play around and see what sounds nice. And then I never developed past that. Totally just headbutted the stand that my camera's on again. Seeing how badly washed out this is, looking over at my live feed for my stream, like, seeing how washed out this looks on camera, I'm just like, oh yeah, this is definitely one that's gonna be a lot better viewed, not as a stream, but, as a scanned and, like, sort of properly adjusted values piece. I got it so I had something to do that wasn't in front of a screen, because I spend literally 16 hours a day at my computer otherwise. Nice, because if I'm hitting a mental wall at work, I just turn around and practice a bit, and it helps detach me from reality a bit. I can come back with a clearer head. That's nice. Yeah, I end up wearing my blue light glasses more often than not, just because I stare at a screen so much now. And I'm just like, yep, this is definitely ruining my eyeballs. And, like, I ended up with a really bad migraine the other day just because I've been staring at screens far too frequently. But it's nice that you have something where you can just sort of, like, turn, get away from the screen, do something to help you with mental blocks and stuff like that. Just right there. That's nice.
transitional lenses for driving and they help with blue light, so I feel that. Downside is these frames weigh a ton and fall off my face religiously. Ooh. Yeah.
I just bought a pair of those, like, $5 super cheap blue light glasses. So I was like, huh, I wonder if these work. And they actually, they work really nice, and I'm glad I did.
Bottom.
I feel like I'm going to have to probably sometime in the next couple years actually start wearing glasses. There's nothing wrong with wearing glasses, but I feel like it will take some getting used to. Wasn't fast enough to catch them. Oh, there's one before that. I looked down at Zelda the other day and asked what she was doing, and she looked up to chirp at me and my glasses fell off. I wasn't fast enough to catch them. They hit her face and she was so betrayed. Oh no! I would have felt awful too. That's terrible. Aria's been being really talkative, like, the past 3 days. Which I'm gonna look at as being a good thing, because for, like, the past week before that, she discovered some place new to hide that no one knows where it is, and she would disappear for, like, hours on end. Like, I'd see her in the morning when she got fed, and then I wouldn't see her again until dinner time. And, like, I would go look for her. I'd be like, okay, I am beginning to be concerned that I haven't seen her. And I'd, like, try and hunt her down. Like, she's got a couple hiding spots that I know about. But she doesn't use them anymore, probably because she found out that I know about them. But, like, I have no idea where she goes. Years. Dappy likes to climb onto the back, into the back of the closet, and I was like, why do you like being so antisocial? Usually sleeps on the couch all day, but every once in a while he's be emo, I guess. Yeah, Ron usually likes to, Ron's kind of like that. He's like out in the living room, like sleeping in the middle of the floor, or like on the couch, or he's got a little like window bench now that he likes. But every once in a while, for example today, he'll be like, nope, I'm gonna go curl up in the bedroom and you're not gonna see me for the rest of the day. Goodbye. I once again apologize for consistently headbutting my camera and making it shake and wobble. It's not intentional, it just keeps happening. Alright, well, I think that does it for the bones.
Yeah, I just noticed that my music stopped. It was like a 2.5 hour loop. So how long have I been streaming for like 2.5 hours? Okay, yeah. So that makes sense. But that also forces me to look at what time it is and be like, oh, hey, I should probably eat something today. So I'm going to actually end my stream and go have lunch now. Just because I need to let this dry before I can go in with my brush pen and like adjust some of the line work. Go eat. Yes, I am. I'm going to go eat. It's not as if I've had absolutely nothing today. I did eat breakfast. I just ate breakfast at like 8 and haven't eaten since. And it wasn't very much for breakfast. But I am going to go eat. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. I enjoyed talking to you guys while doing some art. Here, let me move my light so you can get it better. Actually, let me just turn that off because I'm not going to be in my office when I have lunch. I'm going to go have lunch outside of work. I do all of my work. But I'm working on peeling off the tape now, but there's a decent look at them. I'll have a better, like, fully scanned version of him to post at some point in the near future. Because, like I said, the next day or two, I'm going to be working on scanning all of my stuff that I haven't scanned. And working on getting that posted both on my Twitter and primarily on my Ko-fi. Because I'm going to start, you know, posting there more frequently. And focusing on trying to do that a little bit more. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. I love you all. Have a good rest of your day. Go eat some lunch if you haven't. Thanks for hanging out. Bye!